contact the Church Secretary Dorothea at 440-449-2290. We invite and encourage you to join us in person when you can. All baptized Christians are welcome to share Holy Eucharist with us. The services are followed by a coffee hour where we get to know each other. Today, after the service, there is an organizational meeting for the fish fries. We will be discussing some simplifications to the menu and procedures so that it more closely aligns with the number of people we have. Next Sunday, February 5th, we welcome Father Steve Ashby as he starts his ministry with us. Please plan to stay after services for coffee hour to introduce yourself and to visit with Father Steve. Bring something to share. A sign-up sheet is posted on the bulletin board outside the kitchen. Please wear your name tags. We will ensure that we have name tags for everyone. Let Dorothea know if you don't have one in the tray over there. Father Steve plans to maintain office hours Tuesdays and Thursdays, 9 a.m. to 2 p.m., officially starting Thursday, February 2nd. February 11th, Saturday sessions return. Please join us for Potato Chip Jesus. See the website for more information. Our annual Shrove Tuesday pancake dinner is scheduled for Tuesday, February 21st, starting at 5:30 p.m. and ending at 7:30. The event will be co-hosted with Scout Troop 124. Free will offerings will be accepted. Altar flowers will only be purchased for Sundays when funds for altar flowers were donated in advance. By donating funds for the altar flowers, you can remember a loved one, an event, or simply glorify God. There's a flower sign-up sheet on the bulletin board opposite the coat racks where you can indicate Sunday or Sundays when you would like to donate the flowers. Please include your phone number so that we can contact you for details as to dedication or other instructions. Please consider donating canned packaged dry food to the food pantry baskets in the entrance to the church building. We hope to release the 2023 parish directory no later than mid-March. On the pages that have been laid out on the library table, please make any needed changes in your listings. The next vestry meeting is Thursday evening, February 9th at 7 p.m. Please see block notes and the announcements at the end of today's bulletin for other important information, and let Dorothea know if there are any announcements you want disseminated to the parish. The processional hymn today is hymn 441, In the Cross of Christ I Glory.
Thank you. perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
We'll read Psalm 15 from the Book of the Common Prayer, starting with the refrain and ending with the refrain. The righteous shall abide upon God's holy hill. The Lord who may dwell in your tabernacle, who may abide upon your holy hill.
Whoever believes in life, he does what is right, and speaks the truth from his heart.
There is no guile upon his tongue. He does no evil to his friend. Does not heap contempt upon his neighbor.
In his sight, the wicked is rejected, but he honors those who fear the Lord.
He has sworn to do no wrong, and does not take back his word.
He does not give his money in hope of gain.
First Epistle of St. Paul the Apostle to Corinthians, chapter 1, verse 18 to 31. The message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise and the discernment of the discerning. I will thwart. Where is the one who is wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, God decided through the foolishness of our proclamation to save those who believe. For Jews demand signs, and Greeks desire wisdom. But we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles. But to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ the power of God and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, and righteousness and sanction and redemption, in order that as it is written, let the one who boasts boast in the Lord. This is the word of God, the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Lord, lead our rest of sleep.
Jesus sits down with his disciples and said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit." Or as the New English Bible translates it best, "Blessed are those who know their deed of God. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven." Now, what does it mean to live in poverty of spirit? What does it mean to live, to think and speak and act with an absolute knowledge of your need for God? Well, Jesus then continues by telling us. He says, "Blessed are those who mourn." Jesus says that poverty of spirit is like the grief you feel when someone you dearly love dies. When that happens, nothing else matters. In spirit, you are indifferent to the world around you because you are grounded in your desire to touch and be touched by the one you love, but whom you see no longer. And Jesus wants you to be indifferent to the enticements of the world around you. And he wants you to understand that the one you love and cannot see is God. The one you love and cannot see is God, who is the source of all life and to whom all life returns. Moreover, Jesus says, poverty of spirit is as if some tyrant rules over you or some great terror threatens to descend upon you, driving away all sense of serene and self-confidence and inner strength and personal power, making you meek and powerless. A person whose only option is to entrust himself or herself to fate or to luck, so that in your smallness, you will be overlooked by greatness. And Jesus wants you to know that God is your fate, that God is your good luck. It is God whose greatness of love for you, his defenseless sons and daughters, it is God whose greatness of love for you will overcome the mereness of tyranny and terror. And while he probably could go on, Jesus is content to tell us about poverty of spirit by saying, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Poverty of spirit is finally as if you have been wronged by some crafty cheat and cannot get back what is stolen from you because that cheat is protected by some legal loophole so that neither police nor the courts can touch it. But Jesus wants you to know that God's perfect law has no loopholes, and in the end and ultimately, every cheat and thief and wrongdoer must make eternal restitution. So what does it mean to live in poverty of spirit? It is to be grounded in God with courage and justice. You are fulfilling your duty toward God if you allow your need for Him to make you a person grounded and brave and just. Moreover, these three things, grounding and courage and justice, these three things make it possible for you to fill all your other duties. They make it possible to fulfill your duty to your country and to your neighbor and to yourself. So Jesus says, blessed are the merciful, they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. The person who is poor in spirit, who knows their need for God, who is grounded in God with courage and justice, such a person is merciful. They are merciful not only to those who require it or to those who deserve it. They are, like God, merciful to everyone in everything. Moreover, the altar of the heart of each of God's blessed, the place where those who are poor in spirit have invited God to abide. The altar of the heart of each of God's blessed is not cluttered with trash or filth. God will not share place with unholy attitudes, adulterous desires, or gluttonous appetites. If you need something else in addition to God, you're free to pursue whatever your appetites crave, but you don't get God. And so Jesus teaches us that the person who is poor in spirit, knowing their need of God, must keep their heart pure, must keep their heart as the sanctuary of this holy place is kept, a light with a pure and clear light of Christ who comes to us in the sacrament, aglow with the fire of the Holy Spirit, and if adorned at all, adorned with the beautiful flowers of virtue. Flowers whose beauty are the image of the beauty of God. And then finally, Jesus tells us that to be poor in spirit is to manifest the peace of God. The consequence of mercy and purity and peace, Jesus says, the consequence of mercy and purity and peace is that God's mercy is accessible to the merciful. The consequence of mercy and purity and peace is that God is known in these things. God's presence becomes something that you can almost see and touch. Taste. And the consequence of mercy and purity and peace is that doing them makes us God's children. We become like Christ. Our lives become become sacred. This is the vision of scouting when a boy or a young man promises on his honor to do his best, to do his duty to his country, and to obey the scout law, helping other people of all kinds, and keeping himself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. It is the vision Jesus gives us all when he says, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." Unfortunately, the vision of God's goodness can frighten people. They can't imagine themselves without the things that the world has convinced them they need, that are necessary to prop up their shabby existence. They can't imagine themselves without someone or something to gratify their disordered affections. And being frightened, such individuals will show you contempt, because they are people who are afraid. And so Jesus says, "Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For so men persecuted the prophets who were before you." It is your sacred privilege to be the prophets of this present age. Your faithful lives gladden the heart of God and enhance his efforts to bring the world to its senses. Your sacred living and speaking and thinking and doing offer the world a vision of light which dispels darkness. Your sacred living and speaking and thinking and doing offers the world a vision of the Father who loves her and of his Son, Jesus. And it all begins with doing your duty to God. It all begins with being poor in spirit, knowing your need for God. For yours, your precious life in Christ Jesus, yours is the vision of God which gives life and becomes life everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Let us confess the faith that makes us poor in spirit. Say together the Nicene Creed.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, but of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our sons.
Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls. And to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may be enlightened in your will. Walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Our time.
When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. presenting to you from your creation this bread, this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable for him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection unto you, Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, blessed Bartholomew and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
Yes, now as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, our
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
food, and the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us down to the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
May Christ, the Son of the living God, be manifest in you, that your lives may be a light to the world, and the blessing of God.